not a fair trial. It wasn't in trial. I'm not being allowed to speak how I need to speak. He's stopping me from talking. He's gagging me, putting tape over my mouth at this moment.
So many of you can't stop talking about this. Now the inmate in that chair speaking out about it to the I-team from jail. Tuesday, a Cuyahoga County judge ordered tape over the mouth of Franklin Williams. The judge, frustrated, Williams kept talking during sentencing. Two pieces of tape put on by deputies.
So when they put the tape on my mouth, I felt so humiliated. I just felt like, wow, it's an abuse of discretion of the courtroom. Listening to the duct tape go, I still hear that at night.
Williams now beginning to serve a sentence of 24 years in prison. Judge John Russo sentenced him for armed robberies and more, but not before this.
Mr. Williams, I'm the judge in the matter. Shut your mouth. Do you understand what it means to don't talk?
Yes.
Don't talk. Mr. Williams, be very simple to gag you.
So we had to ask, why didn't he just shut up?
Because the judge would not allow me to talk and get the things that I was trying to say, you know, on record. He would stop me before I was able to explain anything on my behalf.
You should know on that jailhouse phone call, the I-team listened, but we also challenged Franklin Williams. The court says he disappeared in the middle of his trial. He says he doesn't even remember a trial. So we said, come on, you really expect people to believe that?
Yes, sir. I was hit in the head and I didn't receive no medical treatment. I lost my mind. I lost my memory. I don't even remember me going to a trial. That's what I was trying to tell them.
The I-team showed you in December. Williams convicted even though he went on the run in the middle of trial. Judge Russo says he had a right to order this, something Williams clearly never expected.
I've had to silence him because of his disrespect for the system,
disrespect
for the parties.
And I just was so concerned about if my children seeing this, if my family seeing this. I feel that my constitutional right of freedom of speech has been violated.
Let's say 14 years of being a judge, and I've never had to take the extreme that I have. So for the